It's the easiest way to start saving more money overnight. Welcome to The Project. Tonight, how reverting back to paying the old-fashioned way can unlock one of the big secrets of cold, hard cash, potentially saving you thousands.
Forget cryptocurrency, forget tapping your watch. The new monetary craze sweeping the kids is something called cash. Am I saying that right?
I want to encourage everyone to go back to using cash because my savings have gone through the roof compared to what they usually are.
Comedian Matt Hay made the switch back in January and saw his savings shoot up.
Handing over the $100 note and only getting $60 back in change, as opposed to just tapping my card or my phone and purchasing whatever I want and not really thinking about it.
Matt still uses digital payments for bills and rent, but for anything recreational or bought in person, he goes with cash, and that has transformed his spending habits.
The fact that I have to think consciously about everything that I'm purchasing makes me stand there and say, do I really need this?
In one case, we've got a tangible asset. In one case, we've got an intangible asset. That implies that our brain perceives very differently.
I usually use my card.
Always my phone.
Just my phone.
Card.
Card and phone. I use pretty much everything.
Overall, trends have been shifting away from physical currency for a while. And this week, for the first time ever, digital wallets have overtaken cash, accounting for $126 billion in payments over the last year, compared with $105 billion for ATM withdrawals. Cash is now used for only 16% of in-person transactions. That's down from 70% in 2007.
Oh, it really did change after COVID. Convenience outweighs the charges.
Just simplicity. I find that cash isn't accepted at a lot of places.
But there are consequences. It's called the cashless effect. Researchers finding our method of payment matters. And while paying in cash can cause actual psychological pain, also known as the pain of paying, when we tap a phone or a card, it feels less painful. So we spend more.
There have also been some studies that show that the same areas of the brains that are activated when we feel actual physical pain is the same when we actually part ourselves from money.
Which is why the digital native generation is starting to push back. So is it time to consider going back to the old ways?
I have a little satchel filled with coins. Cash is king.
We are live from the lands of the Kulin Nation. It's Monday and we have with us a man who never feels any pain of payment. It's
never, ever.
Steve Rice.
If I could work out how to put the tap and go thing on my phone, I would not.
You'll be all right.
Yeah, I'd be fine.
If you give me all your details, I'll sort it out for you immediately.
We still have coins, do we?
Yeah, we do.
You don't deal in coins, do you?
Cash is incredible, isn't it? I think it's a really good idea to do that, except you go to places like the MCG, for example, where you spend a lot of time, Wally.
Yes.
You can't buy anything.
Yeah.
Because it's cashless.
I like the, you know when you pay with your phone and it makes
no,
that little...
No, because I can't do it.
No, well, I'll talk to the children on the panel. you go, and it goes, and you get a little buzz, like they'll talk. I don't think that's pain. I like it.
That's the point.
That's the point, yeah.
Oh.
Were you not watching the story?
No, I thought it triggered the bat negative. So that's good.
No, when you use cash, you feel the pain because it's real. So you go, oh, my God, a $20 note just left.
Having a cash vibrator in your hand is not a good thing.
Yeah, right. The vibrator? Yeah, you should.
Yeah.
Don't put it in your hand.